Hi all, you are watching a summary of our latest news. Today we are going to focus on the following. How is web development going? What the Cellframe dashboard and KelVPN project teams have been up to? What's new in the marketing department? So make sure that you watch till the end, it will be interesting. According to our tradition, let's kick things off with the web development. Firstly, the most important thing, due to the acceleration of the development of quantum computers, from now on we are forced to limit the period of staking in quantum unsafe networks to 6 months. Namely, LP staking for cell tokens ERC20 and BEP20 is now limited to 6 months. This is a forced measure that will last until we complete the development of emergency algorithms for the emergency evacuation of funds to the native network in the event of a series of quantum hacks. Staking programs in quantum-safe CF20 networks will operate as before. Go ahead. We have completed a refactoring of the Cellframe Explorer backend, the site that displays all transactions on our networks. The new backend has been launched and, as we expected, the site is now faster and more stable. And as usual, we have worked on improving the UI of our sites to make them even more user-friendly. For example, on the Cellframe staking site, we solved the problem of duplicate stake records in the statistics tab, and on the Cellframe migration site, we configured the balance display. Links to all sites will be in the description of this video. Moving on to Cellframe dashboard news. The significant updates here are as follows. The team continues to work on the DEX tab. It updated the logic for changing pairs and updating data on tokens. This resolved an issue where the previously selected pair would be reset when switching tabs. In addition, the application as a whole has corrected the Web3 API outputs to take into account the new node response format via the JSON RPC protocol. The navigation menu icons have also been updated. And now let's continue on to the news of the KelVPN project. The main news from the project team is also related to LP staking. The KelVPN staking site has added a restriction for LP staking of ERC20 and BEP20 KEL tokens. The duration of such staking is limited to 6 months. Let me emphasize once again that this is a forced measure and will last until the Cellframe network team completes the development of emergency algorithms for the emergency evacuation of funds to the native network in the event of a series of quantum hacks. As for staking programs in quantum-safe CF20 networks, they operate as before. The team is also currently working on SEO optimization of the project website and is gradually eliminating various shortcomings. Debugging of the mode of key functionality of KelVPN, the mode of joint operation of the servers and Cellframe dashboard is also ongoing. Let me remind you that this mode will allow users to choose a provider and the most suitable conditions for receiving traffic, and providers in turn will be able to receive a commission for their services. What has been done recently? Added preliminary check of the amount debited by check from the masternode. Optimized requests for connecting to Cellframe dashboard via Web3 API and for reconnecting after restarting one of the applications. As you can see, there is progress, but work is still ongoing, so we will continue to keep you updated on development news for this mode. Now I want to talk a little about the two-way operating mode of the bridge, our most anticipated launch. So in general, we continue to work to improve network synchronization. We have optimized stream channel notifications. Notifiers are needed to detect communication over the stream channel from both sides and increase the efficiency of synchronization. And recently, we implemented a synchronization channel state machine. A state machine is a special mechanism that controls the transition between given states. To make the decision to switch between states, the machine connects to the notification synchronization channel and starts a wait timer. If the channel experiences problems or goes down completely, the machine moves to another client and tries to synchronize with it. If synchronization is successful, the machine goes into a rest state, and after a certain period of time, it tries to synchronize with a new client, which is selected at random. The synchronization channel state machine is one of two basic elements on which the synchronization logic in our network is built. The second element is the epidemic distribution of updates. We will talk about it in more detail in the following issues. For now, let's add that at the moment both elements are working properly in tests on the local network. Therefore, we are now moving on tests on the DevNet. Synchronization is one of the key mechanisms of network operation, so today we decided to talk about it in more detail. But besides this, there are many other important things that we need to do on the way to a two-way bridge regime. Well, a little about marketing. We continue to actively increase our reach on all social networks, which is very clearly visible in the growth in the number of subscribers in our channels. Particular attention is now paid to partner streams. Since the last issue, we have held two with the Crypto Griffons and Crypto Tutkunlari communities. Both of them took place in text format on Telegram. Both turned out to be successful and had a significant impact on the influx of new participants in the Cellframe community. Thanks all for your questions and interest. Of course, the team is now busily preparing for the Blockchain Live Forum. We can expect the guys to make an initial presentation about a new exciting project that will become part of the Cellframe ecosystem. Well, that's all for now. Find more details on our social networks, and in order not to miss anything, subscribe. It's very simple. See you the next time. Bye, everyone.